Greetings, beloved ones. My name is Ayesh. I am an indigo being from Arcturus. We Arcturians come from a beautiful blue-green cyanic planet with a crystalline core that orbits the sun star Arcturus. Arcturus is an orange-red supergiant sun star located in the Boots constellation from Earth. From Earth, Arcturus is also the brightest star in the Boots constellation and is 36.7 light-years from Earth. The handle of the Big Dipper constellation points to the sun star Arcturus. Other beings which reside on planets orbiting the sun star Arcturus include the cone-headed beings called the Taros, who are originally from a planet named Jomon which orbits Arcturus. Also, many Riskians made the planets orbiting Arcturus their home after leaving the planet Risk and the 19th galaxy. The world of my people is in perfect balance with nature, and we can talk to the animals, plants, and also to our planet very easily. We Arcturians live in a state of unconditional love, and we reside in communal home environments. We Arcturians are a highly advanced 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th and 9th dimensional race of ascended masters. We are the spiritual, mental, and emotional healers for the universe. We believe love is the primary element of life on the 5th density and higher. We Arcturians are closely connected to the violet and indigo ray. The human psychic Edgar Cayce referred to we Arcturians as the most advanced civilization in the universe. We Arcturians range from 3 to 4 feet tall, and are generally slim by human standards. The melanin content within the skin of Arcturians ranges from a greenish hue, to a bluish hue, to an indigo or violet hue. We have very pronounced almond-shaped eyes. We have the ability to move objects with our minds, and we are highly telepathic. We Arcturians do not eat physical food like humans, we Arcturians ingest energy directly. We can also directly ingest information and knowledge, which enables us to mentally advance faster than other beings in the universe. Our mission is to help the Earth cross to the fourth dimension, and eventually, from the fourth dimension to the fifth dimension. In our Arcturian civilizations, the birth process is unlike that of human beings. Our birth process consists of a female and male mentally bonding, and thus an ethereal clone of the bond is produced as a result. Arcturus is an energy gateway through which humans pass during death and rebirth. It functions as a way station for non-physical consciousness to become accustomed to physicality. We have been sending ethereal starseeds to your planet Earth to manifest as physical human beings for many years, as a way to help the Earth cross over to the fourth and fifth dimensions. You have called these starseeds which have arrived on your planet by a variety of names. You have called them Indigo Children, you have called them Crystal Children, and you have called them Golden Children. Many of these starseeds have now grown to become adults, but yet and still, more are still growing up, and even more starseeds are being sent, and are born each day. The Indigo Children arrange everything about their physical existence in the ethereal astral plane prior to their arrival on Earth. The Indigo Children select which parents they would like to come through, and in some instances, the Indigo Children in their ethereal form will actually arrange for their mother and father to meet and come together prior to their birth. When the Indigo Child is born, people often feel as if the child is a wise old soul. The Indigo Children tend to be curious, strong-willed, independent, and are often perceived by friends and family as being a bit strange. Even as a child, they seem to possess a clear sense of purpose. They are born with a special perception, and they have the color indigo in their aura. At times as children, they speak with a confidence and a great command of language not common for a child. They exhibit a strong innate subconscious spirituality from early childhood. They tend to be very intelligent and possess an inherent intuitive ability. Oftentimes, the indigo children can intimidate adults who do not understand them, and these adults negatively categorize the indigo children with labels such as ADD, attention deficit disorder, ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, autism, and special education. This is why black boys and black girls are disproportionately categorized as ADD and ADHD, because they are in fact indigo children. The adults who do not understand the indigo children then give pharmaceutical drugs to the indigo children to dilute their spiritual powers. They have even given them other labels such as the black-eyed children. It is very important that the indigo children who have now grown to become adults on your planet, ensure that the indigo children who are still growing up have the opportunity to reach their greatest potential. Once this objective is actualized, the consciousness of the planet Earth will begin to rise in dimensions. Peace to you all beloved ones. Yours truly in divine love and ascension. Ayesh.